Hello everyone, welcome to this post. Here we are solving the questions that were given in the NEET examination May 2006, happened on May 1st. This particular question belongs to fluids or fluid statics to be particular. It is given in the problem that two non-mixing liquids, they are not going to mix, they are different, they are having different densities. You might have noticed that second one is having a higher density, greater than 1, because n rho, where n is greater than 1, is going to have a higher density than that of the first one. First one is going to have a lower density, and they were put in a container. So if you try to draw a diagram for this, it will be simply like this. There is a big container. This big container is having two kinds of liquids. The upper liquid will be rho, the lower liquid will be having a density n rho, because the n rho is a denser liquid, it shall be at the bottom of the system. The height of the each liquid is equal to h, each liquid is having some height. A solid cylinder of length L and a density D is put in this container. It is put in this container in such a way that cylinder floats with axis vertical and length rho L in the denser container. So if you try to draw the cylinder, it will be like this. It is having a length rho L inside the, it is having a density, having a length, it is not rho L, it is given like a PL, having a length L with its length P. So this is PL inside a denser liquid. It is also given that the total length of the system is L. So this length will become automatically L minus PL. This is how the system is settled in the two liquids. Then what is the density of these two liquids are? Here the point is simple, that what are the forces acting on the system? Obviously the weight of the system is acting in the downward direction, because the system is in two liquids, there is upthrust due to the first one, who is pushing it in upward direction, and there is an upthrust due to the second one, who is also pushing the body in a upward direction. In that particular scenario, the system is in a balanced state, therefore it is in a kind of an equilibrium. So to get that equilibrium, what happened is weight is balanced by the upthrust of the first liquid and the sum of the upthrust of the second liquid. This is how we shall proceed in solving this problem. We know the formula for the weight is nothing but equal to mg, where m is the mass of the cylinder, which is not given for you. We can write that mass as volume into density. We can write volume of the body, density of the body into g, who is equal to weight, is equal to the upthrust. Upthrust is volume of the fluid displaced in the first case, density of the fluid, and gravity, plus upthrust due to the second liquid is volume of the fluid displaced, second fluid displaced, density of the fluid too, and acceleration due to gravity. Because g is common for all of them, we can cancel. We can also write this volume as area into length, because area of the cylinder is common every time, that area also gets cancelled. So how it will be? Area into length of the cylinder, which is given like L, and the density of that body equal to volume of the fluid 1, could be again written like area into length of the cylinder in fluid 1. That's nothing but L minus PL. Density of the fluid is given like first fluid is given like rho. volume of the fluid displays this volume of the cylinder in the second fluid or in the lower fluid. That could be written like area. Length is like PL. Density of that fluid is nothing but equal to N rho. Now we can cancel even the area who is in common for all of them. Then we will be getting an equation. Length into density of that cylindrical body is equal to, we can rearrange the terms just by multiplying, and we can further get this term L being common everywhere, we can just cancel it. Density of the cylinder is rho minus P rho L plus L is of course already got cancelled, need not write it. P rho and N. Therefore, by taking the rho in common, we can write 1 minus P plus P N is the density of that cylinder. We can take even P common inside. So, by taking that rho in common, what we have taken is rho 1 minus, even if I take the P as common further by taking say plus P, and I will be getting a N minus 1. This is the density of the body or the density of the cylinder. So, what we have applied is just a formula of the fluid statics, that the when a body is in equilibrium in a liquid, weight is balanced by the upthrust. Thank you.